Drop it.
I can't do that.
Now, look, I don't want this coming down to a face-off, son.
I'll take my chances. You're gonna hang me anyway.
I think you're innocent.
Then let me go after Emmett. He's the only one that can clear me.
Well, I'll be damned. I seem to be out of ammo.
Nathaniel Pickett.
Nice shot.
We know one thing. He didn't spend his money on soap. I'll supply the drinks. What say you get dinner?
Deal.
camouflage for the help. Help?
I saved your life.
Maybe. Maybe I could have handled it myself.
Uh-huh.
Why'd you do it?
I've been watching them follow you for a couple of days. As we all seem to be headed the same direction. Figured I'd rather camp with you than him. You know, save a man's life in China. The man you saved has to dedicate his whole life to the one who did the saving.
It's a good thing we're in New Mexico.
Yeah. That old horse of mine seems to be on his last legs. Smoke?
No.
So, where exactly did you say you was headed?
I didn't.
Why do you think that ugly sumbitch is trying to kill you anyway?
Maybe he thought I talked too much.
Me? I'm headed to Las Tunas. Gotta be there in 3 days, a whole lot of people gonna be let down.
You get pretty tired carrying that nag.
So that's where it's gonna be?
I ain't got nothing against you, Pickett. It's just the less people I know, the less people get killed.
Until you need your life saved again.
I didn't ask you for any help. Don't.
What?
Don't be playing that. There's one thing I can't put up with, it's harmonica music.
So long as you don't ask me for any favors.
I can't imagine you taste very good. So I might as well ride you.
Thank you.
beloved Michael Flynn into your hands, secure in the knowledge that he is in a higher place now, where he can look down upon us, smile. Captain Dryden?
Michael Flynn has been taken from us by the very forces from which I have been sworn to protect you. In a sense, my loss is greater than yours. At least we can learn something from Michael Flynn's death. We can be reminded that evil can come to us in many ways. Evil can be right here among us. Or it can come riding into town when least expected. Friends, if beauty is to be our utopia, we must be forever vigilant. Then, as has been proven, justice will prevail. For what good is beauty without justice?
Like that horse knows you.
He ought to. He's mine.
You ain't the fellow who was riding him earlier.
That fellow wouldn't happen to be around here, would he?
Poor fellow. He's in jail. He killed the newspaper man, Mr. Flynn. Gonna be a hanging. My mom says I don't have to go if I don't want him. So how come you're here? You see the hanging?
I ain't much for hangings either. Who do I talk to about getting my horse back?
Well, Captain Dryden says he belongs to the town now. And they're gonna auction him off after the hanging.
Who's Captain Dryden?
Well, everybody knew Captain Dryden. He's in charge of the whole town. He's the one that lets me work here sometimes during the day. For free.
What's your name?
Fletch.
Fletch. You do a good job. What time you close up around here?
It's around dark. Oh, maybe earlier today. The back gate. It's always open. You want to see your horse?
Here you go.
What's it for?
Buy your ma a present.
Thank you.
Whiskey.
What's a man got to do around here to stop people from staring at him?
Well, the last stranger that rode into town wound up killing somebody.
That don't mean we're all bad.
I guess you're right about that. But Michael Flynn was a good man.
Well, then here's to him.
So, what brings you to Beauty?
Looking for a man named Emmett. I heard he might have worked here.
He did. He don't know more. He moved on. If you could pay up, I need to go check some stock. No offense.
None taken.
Is that Emmett Redmond you're talking about?
It's one name he goes by.
What do you want with him?
I need him to straighten out a little misunderstanding for me. Do you know him?
Enough to figure out he's no good.
You know why he left town?
Uh-huh. Do you?
Ma'am, I need to know.
Not here.
Ma'am?
We can't talk here. I'm only trying to do you a favor.
The last time somebody tried to do me a favor, they stole my horse.
Allow me once again to offer my condolences on the death of Mr. Flynn. We all know how very much he meant to you.
Michael Flynn said he wouldn't spit on you if you were on fire. Save your condolences for someone who believes you.
Very nice what you said to the captain, especially in front of his wife.
At least they were at the funeral.
That's right. Where were you?
Being nice to people is what beauty's all about.
Me?
Who the hell are you?
Aren't you going to tell me this is none of my business?
We're the law around here.
I ain't from around here.
You?
Let the girl go.
Hold it right there, cowboy. Your gun. Now.
I'm behind a woman that's about as low as being dead.
Lower than being dead.
You tell me. Go.
Do that. Put it down.
Sorry about having to borrow your horse. I made sure they took real good care of him.
kid, I ain't gonna kill you. Town's gonna take care of that.
It's time I leveled with you. I don't know if I could trust you back at the river.
You didn't know if you could trust me.
I was carrying a lot of money. $2,000.
You get that the same way you got my horse?
It was honest money. There's 20 of us. Families. We come all the way from Georgia with $2,000 and a deed on some land just north of here. It was our land. All I had to do was get the money to the land office in Las Tunas in the next 3 days. What happened? I stopped here for the night. I have a couple of drinks. And next thing I know, I wake up in a courtroom with a hell of a headache, no money, and a death sentence around my neck for killing a man I never even met.
Figured I don't believe this, but I feel that you're about to ask me for a favor.
I'm asking you for what you owe me.
I don't owe you.
I saved your life.
I could have handled it myself.
Remember the proverb.
Get the Chinese to help you.
It ain't just me. Anybody's gonna be able to go up there with a little bit of money and steal my people blind.
Stole my horse.
And Marcus Dryden.
Am I free to go?
Mind if we talk first?
Seems to me we already are.
Did quite a job on my men. A couple of them are going to be out of commission for some time.
That was my intention.
I'm curious. Would you have shot Fury even though he was holding a girl?
What do you think?
I think you ought to consider coming to work for me. Now that I'm short-handed.
I don't make very good deputy material.
No, I'm not a sheriff. My men and I are former Union soldiers hired to keep the peace.
That's all that really needed?
The presence of men like this murderer picket's proof enough. That's just the beginning.
How do you figure?
My friend, the railroad's coming. Right through the middle of town. That means changes. Either good or bad.
And you're planning on making sure it's good?
Well, I'm already making sure. My men and I strive to make beauty the perfect place for families, people to live, kids to grow up.
Somebody like Pickett comes through?
Well, we ask them to leave. They're smart, they do. Pickett decided to stay and got himself in a whole mess of trouble.
Who decides?
Marcus, I'm ready to go back to the ranch now.
wife, Hannah.
How about the job?
I don't think I'd be very comfortable here.
I wanted to thank you for helping me out yesterday.
You ever been to China?
No.
Good.
I never told you about Emmett. I know a place we can talk.
You all right? Yesterday?
I'm fine. Thank you. The name's Caitlin Jones.
About Emmett.
It's where I live. It'll be safer to talk in there.
Just what are you afraid is going to happen if people hear what you got to say?
Same thing that happened to Michael Flynn. I'll be killed.
Ma'am. Not that it's any of my concern, but how could a horse thief killing the town newspaper man have anything to do with you talking to me?
That color man didn't kill Michael Flynn.
Is that a fact?
I think Dryden had Flynn killed. I think Flynn knew something and Dryden was afraid the whole town was going to find out about it. I think
that living behind the newspaper is going to your head.
What are you doing back here anyway?
I worked for the newspaper. Michael Flynn was my uncle.
She worked fine, don't she?
Yeah.
My uncle never trusted Dryden. Said he'd seen enough of snake oil salesmen to know there was something about him that wasn't right.
And what'd he do about it?
He went to Chicago about 3 weeks ago. Said he needed to talk to some friends there about him. When he came back, he was really excited, but he didn't have enough time to tell me anything before. You see, if he's got some proof, it's in a strong box at the bank. If I could get a hold of that, I know I could bust this story wide open.
Well, if you're next to kin like you say you are, you're entitled to it.
You see, it's not that easy. Michael Flynn wasn't my legal uncle. He was my father's best friend. When my father died, I came to live here. No one suspects anything. And I'm the only one that can find out the truth. I'm just so alone.
I know the feeling. Ma'am, I don't know how I can help you.
Well, I guess we all got our own set of problems, don't we?
Do you know anything about Emmett?
Emmett Redmond left here, headed north for Albuquerque. I would imagine he'd be on the train that leaves there tomorrow night. If you leave now, you should be able to catch him.
Okay, grab hold now.
Captain Dryden says you're gonna be leaving.
That's all right.
There was a lady here earlier. She said she wanted to buy your horse.
I don't think she wanted you to leave.
Get it all straightened out, Fletch.
Not according to my brother.
That's the lady who wanted to buy your horse.
Fletch, would you go outside and make sure I get on my rig?
Sure thing.
The boy's right. I did want to keep you in town. My name's Molly Pickett. My brother tells me he saved your life. And now you gonna leave him here to hang?
I got mixed feelings about it. Your brother stole my horse. They hang men for stealing horses.
Nate said he borrowed your horse.
Nate says a lot of things.
If he really wanted to rob you, why didn't he take your money?
Well, he said he had $2,000. Maybe all he needed was a fast horse to put some distance between him and the men he stole it from.
He was riding ahead to make sure he got the land payment to Las Tunas in time. Truth is, he fell behind stopping to save your life from a bounty hunter. Nate found a wanted poster in the pocket of the man that was trying to kill you. Had your picture on it. He showed it to me.
You believe everything you read?
Don't make much difference what I believe. What do you think the town's gonna believe?
I don't give a damn what this town believes.
My people are camped outside of town waiting to start a new life. That money in the land it was gonna buy was everything we had, our hopes and our dreams. Without our land, we got nothing. And without my brother, I got nothing. I ain't got no money to convince you. But I got myself. That's a small price to pay for my brother's freedom.
I don't think he'd agree.
Wonderful job with the porch, Ben.
Thank you, ma'am.
Marcus, have you seen the porch? Ben's just finished.
Maybe later, dear. Evans and I have some business to attend to. I'd appreciate it if we weren't disturbed.
You're right. That fellow Pickett, he has an option on a 100-acre parcel just north of Las Tunas. Prime land.
And the option runs out?
Same day as a hanging.
Excellent.
I got your deposit to the Las Tunas land office. As soon as Pickett's option lapses, the land is yours.
Ah. Evans. You do good work.
That's not all. Three new parcels just came on the market. People figure their neighbors must be keeping some kind of bad news to themselves. Place has become a gold mine.
How much will we need for these new land purchases?
More than we've needed so far.
I think it's time for another town meeting.
You might want to send a man up to Las Tunas. Not everybody wants to sell their land.
That's already taken care of.
save me an extra minute.
What happened?
He killed them all.
Why?
I smelled smoke. It was too late when I got here. I'm with the railroad, surveying.
The railroad's going through Beauty.
No. Stunis. You know, it just ain't right. Oh, 20.
I've got to have a couple of words with Evans. I'm worried about Darnell. He was supposed to return last night after visiting a few homesteaders who refused to sell.
You think something might have happened to him?
I don't know.
When I first learned that the railroad was coming to Beauty, I knew in my heart that you, with your intelligence and foresight, would respond as you did, and quickly. The stock you have purchased in our land development company has gone a long way towards assuring you and your children of wealth and security for the rest of your lives.
Without you,
Captain. Nor I without you. All of you. Well, I called you here tonight for even better news. I have learned that not only is the railroad going to pass through Beauty, but a station is going to be built large enough to accommodate a line change. A larger station means more people, and those people will want more land, and they'll take it. Unless we're as intelligent and foresightful as we have been and get it first. This is our big chance, friends. And our biggest challenge.
Pardon me, Captain Dryden, but what more can we do? I mean, speaking for myself and most of the folks here, we've already given you all we have.
You may think so, but I believe there's more. There has to be more. We've got to dig deeper, friends. For everything we've done so far, everything we've accomplished, will be swept away. Gone. So you see, folks, it's up to you.
Well, I suppose I could sell my wagon.
I knew you could do it, Zeke. Now, that's the kind of leadership we need in this community. Come on, John, Erna, Zeb, Sarah, stand up and sign. Lead us into a brighter future. Lead Beauty into the future. Come on. That's right. Now, when you've all signed up, there's wonderful refreshments lined up on this table over here. I want you to help us.
Right here. Let's go for another 5 minutes.
You two, get the hell out of here.
Leave him, he's dead.
Come over here and get your friend.
Carry him back to that cell. Close the door.
mouth.
I'll be right behind you. Go on.
I got men out looking for them, but,
Make sure they have directions how to get back to town, or we'll never see them again. Evan, something's going on. It's hard to keep the advantage when you don't know what the game is.
How are we going to find out?
Ask him. I'll give you one chance to make it easy on yourself. I want to know what that damn cowboy is doing with your bunch. And I want to know where they're hiding out. I want you to take him back to my ranch and beat the truth out of him. I don't care what it takes. Just make sure he's still alive for the hanging. It's time we take care of Caitlin Jones, too.
How bad is he? He said he can go on.
Don't get that bullet out of there. He ain't gonna make it through the night.
Get out.
Yeah. He's sleeping. You were right to make a stop here. I want to thank you for helping us out back in town. My brother said you were a good man.
It's quite a compliment coming from a horse thief.
Your helping us proves he's right. Cold night.
It's gonna get even colder. We're gonna have to put that fire out now that you're done.
I could stay here and keep you company while you're on watch.
I think we're safe. I think I'll put that fire out.
How's it doing? Still sleeping? What took you so long?
All I got. We're gonna have to make do.
Get him down. We were supposed to have been back here last night. What happened?
We ran into trouble.
Nate?
We didn't get him.
What about Innes?
Dead.
Who's he?
Name's McCall. He helped us, Daniel.
And the woman?
She helped me.
I told you it was a mistake to go.
It's a land swindle.
Dryden's got the whole town giving him money to buy land and beauty.
Thank you. It's got them all believing that the railroad's going through there.
And it ain't.
It's going up north instead, someplace called Las Tunas.
That's where our land is.
Well, my hunch is that the minute your option's up, that land's going to have Dryden's name on it. I'd say he's buying up that land as fast as possible. I know for a fact that he's burning out those who won't sell.
That means we ain't got nothing.
He's right, McCall. We ain't got nothing. And we don't care nothing about the railroad. Our money's gone. And our land is gone. And there ain't nothing we can do about it. And his being dead proves that.
If most people had gone with us...
Damn it, Molly! Have you forgot? We didn't come here to fight. We came here to get away from fighting. Nate Picker's gonna die. And there ain't nothing we can do that won't end up with more of us hanging next to him. I say we pack up and move out.
I got something to say, Daniel.
Please, hear me out. I might have agreed with you yesterday. About leaving, that is. But that was my boy that died. Now Henry's gone. And I'll shoot the man myself who killed him. But that's no reason we should allow the same people to hang Nate Pickett.
There ain't nothing we can do to save Nate Irma.
I think there might be. What you people gotta do is prove that Dryden's a liar. I think we can do that.
You've done enough.
Why you want to help us?
Because I know what it's like to have somebody else's noose around your neck.
I didn't mean to sound ungrateful to you earlier.
I understand.
Oh, no, you don't. The fact that you helped Molly and Cyrus, well, that was a brave and honorable thing for you to do. We're indebted to you for it.
You don't owe me nothing.
Maybe an explanation. It was the actions of Molly and Cyrus that angered me. Violence is something we all came here to avoid.
With all due respect, Daniel, a group like yours in this country is a lot of trouble and not a lot of law.
Well, we've seen worse, believe me.
Where?
In the finest Negro fighting force ever assembled. The 9th U.S. Cavalry.
I've heard of you people. Some say that you were the finest fighting force of any color.
Well, we were 200 strong. By the time the war was over... Well... We decided that... Not much good comes from all that dying.
Sometimes freedom has a high price.
Too high for me, boy.
Don't get.
got something you might want to see.
Marcus.
Get this mess cleaned up, will you?
Had this stashed. Never did talk, though. He's a tough man.
A lot of good it'll do him tomorrow. A tough man's neck doesn't take any longer to break than a coward's. Murder, bank robbery.
It's a whole lot of trouble.
It can't be trouble for us. This fellow McCall could hurt us in a lot of ways. I want you to make sure he doesn't. And this time, no slip-ups.
Get to work.
The doors are here and the counter's here. Now, this is the back room. This is where my uncle's strong box would be.
All right.
Let me help you.
No, ma'am.
I helped you once before.
I know you did, and I thank you for that, but robbing a bank is a whole other thing.
Have you ever done it?
No, ma'am. But I got a reputation for it, so I might as well. Where can I get some dynamite?
Right there. Get your hands up. Get up against the wall. Okay.
You didn't want to help the boy at all, did you? You just wanted the money.
It's not going to make a lot of difference to you.
Hey, what's that supposed to mean? You smell smoke.
Uh-huh.
Gotta be McCall or what's left of him. That's his coat.
Body at the bank.
Good. Alert the men that are moving up the hanging to tomorrow morning. No sense waiting around all day. And Evans, I want you to spend everything we got at the meeting last night. Go to Las Tunas and purchase every last piece of land you can get your hands on.
Sure thing.
I think it's time we closed out this chapter of Beauty's history.
After I heard the explosion, I was afraid you weren't going to come back.
Where's the box?
No, I haven't opened it yet. I'll have you to take care of it. Come on. Drink this.
It's whiskey. What are you doing with whiskey?
We all have our secrets. I guess you missed out on your chance to find Emmett.
There'll be another chance.
What did he do to you? I need to know.
Why?
Because I need to know you.
Feels like a long time ago. Emmett killed a man. Skipped town. I was framed for the murder.
Does he know that you're after him?
Yep. Every time I come into a town, he's just left. Sometimes it's 3 days. Sometimes it's more than a month. Seems every time that I get really close to him,
something or someone gets in your way.
So I keep on moving.
Do you think?
No. No, I can't stop, Kate. Not until I find him. Boy, I wish I could.
Do you? then I guess it'll have to be enough.
Sit down, Molly. Yeah, I've learned there's 30 acres of good farming land near Reading. If we work hard, we can make enough for a down payment in no time.
We've done the hard work for our land. Now we got to fight for it.
This time is going to be different, Molly.
No, Daniel. It ain't never going to be no different. No one is going to hand us anything on a silver platter. That's just the way it is. We got to do what's right.
According to who, McCall?
He's dead. Dryden's men killed him. This ain't just about my brother.
Isn't it?
No. It's about the others. All of us. Every damned one of us, Daniel. We need a cause. We need something to believe in. You have got to give us something to believe in now. Or we gonna come apart.
Schedule's been moved up. You're gonna die early, so you don't ruin anybody's dinner. No!
The report's here about Dryden from New York and Chicago.
This is the man's dishonorable discharge.
Yeah. It says here that he and a band of renegade Union soldiers were accused of selling battle plans to the Confederates.
Look at this, Kate. This is a map of the railroad going through Las Tunas. This is the proof we need.
I knew Michael was right. I knew it.
We may be able to save Pickett and nail Dryden.
How?
Can we get through that door?
It's boarded shut.
Captain Dryden's been looking for something here.
The press.
Can you fix it?
I sure as hell can try.
Marcus, I'd rather not go into town today.
Nonsense. It's the most important day in the history of beauty. Come along. I want Ben to take that wagon.
You didn't want to see the hanging.
I don't. I'm here to stop it.
You better hurry.
I got till this afternoon.
Captain Dryden moved it up. It's gonna be soon. I gotta get out of here.
I need your help, Rusch.
Stop the hanging?
Stop the hanging.
All right.
Fixed.
I hope so.
The hanging's been moved up.
I'll have to. The poses I set type.
Rusch is going to help you.
I'll do anything you say.
I'll see you when it's over.
Now we need a couple hundred more. You was dead.
Good. Where you going?
I'm gonna get me a rifle and I'm gonna blow that hanging rope in two.
You that good?
I'm that good. What about you? What you gonna do?
I'm gonna back you up. Come on.
Figure we got?
Close to 200, I think.
Is it gonna be enough?
It's gonna have to be. Come on, we can get out the back and round behind the crowd without being seen.
Fine piece of construction. Let's give it a real test.
Says an eye for an eye.
Yes, sir, Captain.
I say we have much more to gain than just retribution today for the death of Michael Flynn.
My hope will come away from here.
Better understanding of what I've done. Although the process of this learning may be painful, it's necessary to understand the extent of the devotion. So, the power vested in me by you, the people of beauty, I order this execution. Proceed.
Be up there soon enough.
Wait a minute. Something's wrong here.
Dryden sold us out. Dryden tricked us.
Thank you.
know just what I mean.
You've done good, Fletch.
Okay. I knew you had something to do with this.
It's over.
We're riding.
Gone. And I think he got Caitlin with him. He headed towards the mountain.
Lay the guns down, boys. Put them down. I'm in it. Put them down.
Nice shot.
You ought to frame that, Kate. It's your first paper being the new editor.
I know you have to go.
I don't mean I won't come back.
Well, he'll be back. I've got to come through beauty to visit us in Las Tunas.
Before you go, there's something I got to admit to you.
What's that?
I did steal your horse.
There's something I got to admit to you, too.
Yeah?
I don't think I could have handled that bounty hunter. You might have saved my life.
You saved mine. So we're even.
You stole my horse.
I knew I should have kept my mouth shut.
Take care, friend.
You too.
I almost forgot. Just don't be planted around me.